You just made a very important observation. Some scripts don't modify the DOM or the CSS OM, and really they shouldn't block rendering, and analytics is a great example.
Yeah, I wish we had some way to tell the browser exactly that.
Actually, we can. One strategy would be to load the script after the page is loaded, so when the browser fires the unload event, and we could execute the script then.
All right, how would I do that?
The browser fires an unload event when the page is finished loading, and you could wait for that and then execute your script then. Check the instructor notes for instructions on how to do that.
Okay, will do. Is there anything else?
Yeah, the onload technique is a good one to have in your back pocket, but there's actually an even simpler strategy that we could use. All we need is an extra attribute on the script tag. Let me show you.
Cool.
I've pulled out our analytics code into a separate file and added the async attribute to the script tag. This attribute has two important properties. First, it tells the browser that it does not have to block DOM construction when it encounters the script tag. As a result, the browser dispatches the script request and continues parsing the DOM. Second, the execution of the script also does not block on the CSS object model. So, if the script is available before the CSS object model is ready, it can still be executed right there and then.
Oh wow, that's handy. So async basically means that the script does not block the critical rendering path.
Exactly. The browser will download and execute the script, but it won't block the parser, and it won't block on CSS.
What about inline scripts? Can I put an async attribute on an inline script?
Unfortunately, that wouldn't work. Inline scripts will always block on the CSS object model. Well, with one exception. If you put your JavaScript above your CSS, then it will execute without blocking on CSS. To learn more about this pattern and async scripts, check out the link in the instructor notes. Let's do a quick exercise to see if you can spot the difference between these patterns.